because it will be difficult, and it is difficult, but if you want to do it, you just have to kind of charge in and get on with it, essentially. My name is Annabel Sharkey. I'm a cardiothoracic surgeon, and I took 3 years out of my cardiothoracic training to do a PhD at the University of Leicester. My PhD was looking at patients with mesothelioma, which is a kind of lung cancer, and basically looking at the genetics of mesothelioma to see how the genetics of the tumour affected how patients respond to treatment, different types of treatment. If I hadn't done my PhD, I almost definitely wouldn't be able to have an academic career or a reasonable academic career in academic medicine. So it's been invaluable from that side of things if I want to carry on doing research. It's also brought me together with lots of people nationally and internationally that I can collaborate with, open doors in terms of jobs. You know, I helped to organise one of the international meetings. There's lots of things that weren't just part of the PhD itself and the science part of it that actually doing the PhD helped with. So working during this COVID pandemic has obviously been horrendous for most of us. But I think it's actually brought together the department that I work in, everybody as a team, incredibly well. In comparison to how we worked before, all the different levels of people from the consultants, the anaesthetist surgeons to the cleaners, everybody, we all had to work together to be able to work safely. I work in a very male-dominated specialty. Cardiothoracics historically has been very male-dominated, but there are more women coming through now in training and getting consultant jobs. And I think one of the only ways to combat that is, conversely, to have more women doing the job. That in itself is difficult because advertising it to women is very difficult. It's hard work. You have to sacrifice a lot in your life outside of work. You know, the idea of part-time work doesn't go down very well usually with your male colleagues, but the more women that are involved, that will make it more easy for junior women to come through and train in the specialty. One of the things that one of my friends pointed out to me that I didn't realise was the value of having a role model in your whatever you choose to do, your whatever field it is. If you feel like there aren't very many women in that field, find somebody who is a woman, who is successfully doing that job, and speak to them and have them as a role model, basically. My top tips for anybody thinking of undertaking a PhD or any other higher degree would be choose something or a field that you're actually genuinely interested in studying, because if you're not interested, it becomes incredibly difficult. Make sure you have some funding in place so you can actually get paid, and expect things to go wrong throughout the entire thing, and don't be disheartened by it, because if you take a step back, even though everything is going wrong, it's still all very interesting, and it's all new things that you're learning, new people that you're meeting, and the whole PhD study, the whole 3 years or however long you do it over, as a whole, is a much better and more fulfilling experience. It's not just going to work and doing the research that you're doing or whatever it is that your PhD is on. So that would be my top tips. Doing a viva during the coronavirus pandemic was interesting. My external examiner was from Australia, so obviously couldn't come over here. And the rest of the department were all in Leicester, and I live in Sheffield. So we had to do it over Microsoft Teams, which was strange, but actually it was quite good fun. I would recommend it to anybody. It won't do your career prospects in any harm whatsoever. Even if you do something completely different to what your PhD has been studying, that doesn't matter. The things that you learn from doing a PhD outside of your specific area of research are so huge that I would recommend anybody do it.